When we look at chondrules, individual chondrules, and their rare earth element patterns, we observe that these patterns are typically flat. And this is what is shown in this plot here. Now, this is one wide plot. And this is because there are 400 patterns displayed. And the reason for showing all these patterns is to really demonstrate that most of them are really flat, and that it is not that if I would just show five patterns that I selected, five that are flat. But as you can see here, most of them are really flat. So let's have a closer look. First of all, this is a category plot. So on the x-axis, there are categories, which are in this case the various rare earth elements. On the y-axis, there's a concentration of the element normalized to CI chondrites. Now, importantly, the y-axis has a linear scale. Very often, rare earth element patterns are displayed with a logarithmic scale because the fractionations between, for example, the light and the heavy rare earth elements are so extreme that a logarithmic scale is required. This is not the case here. So that's quite critical because this shows that the patterns are really, most of them, rather flat. There are a couple of slight wiggles, but in general, they're mostly flat. Also, they are slightly enriched relative to CI. So CI is here, and they are slightly enriched by a factor of maybe something like 1.5. Now, the flat patterns tell us that the material from which chondrules formed cannot have been fractionated. So it's not possible that the chondrules come from melt on a big planetary body, and this melt, if there's a melt, usually minerals start to crystallize, for example, and then fractionation happens of the various heavy and light rare earth elements, for example. And we might expect patterns, something like this, that we know from Earth, terrestrial samples, or something like this. That's not what we observe, or only in very rare cases, but not in the typical case. So chondrules must have come from material that was unfractionated and slightly enriched in refractory elements. Now, this slight enrichment most likely was not CAIs, because CAIs often have fractionated rare earth element patterns, and we might observe these patterns then also in the chondrules. Some chondrules have these kind of patterns, so we can observe these, but in general, we don't see it. So in general, the enrichment is not because CAI material was added to the chondrules, but because the precursors were slightly enriched in refractory element, which makes sense because chondrules are high temperature condensates. Now, if you're interested to look in more detail for individual chondrites, so we can, of course, use, for example, MetBase, and then go here to the component database and select maybe something like CV chondrites, and then go to the category, or it's already shown here, so I just put click on plot, and then here are the rare earth element patterns for CV chondrules. And again, you see they're all flat because this is the same database I used for the other plot here. For the light rare earth elements, you can see that some are quite enriched. And there are CAIs that are enriched in light rare earth elements. So in these cases, we might really see the contribution of CAIs to some of the chondrules. But in general, there is none. So what we can learn from this is, as said and in summary, chondrules must have come from precursor material of chondrules came from an unfractionated source, slightly enriched in refractory elements, and this might have been the solar nebula itself. It is unlikely it was a larger parent body.